Saputra in the red.
Ooh, there's that calf kick Rich Franklin was talking about as Danny Kingad shoots in. Really hard to take down Eko Roni Saputra. Heavy wizard coming on the left side of Eko.
Kingad firing shots at him. Oh, and then reversal pumps. This is outstanding stuff.
This is not something that we expected from Kingad to actually out-wrestle Saputra, but when we talked to Kingad this week, he said, he actually said, we got a surprise. We brought in some wrestlers. We brought in some Iranian wrestlers. He didn't want to give me any names. He didn't want to ruin the surprise, but he said, I got something for you on this one, Rich.
And he had something for you with a beautiful suplex right there to put Eko Roni Saputra as Danny Kingad is able to get both hooks in and possibly secure the back position. Going to be very important for Eko Roni Saputra to pay close attention to what Danny Kingad is doing. He's going to try to spin into the guard, but Kingad's able to settle the position and then lock in the body triangle. Bad spot for Eko Roni Saputra to start the fight.
Kingad got him right where he wants in the opening minute of this fight.
Kingad said in an interview this week, he said Saputra is not the same level wrestler that Kyra Akhmatov was. He said, I'm not concerned about going down to the ground with him. Nonetheless, I still didn't expect to see this in the match.
Yeah, I've been on the mat with Eko Roni Saputra, and he is an incredible grappler, really strong everywhere. But right now, he needs to try to put his weight on that foot side, which he does, and now he needs to try to separate this body triangle, right? He's got the hands defended. He's defending the choke fine, but he has to break free of this body triangle. He can try to get his right leg underneath the foot of Danny Kingad to possibly relieve some of that pressure. But right now, he's kind of stuck in this position. Eko Roni Saputra has the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu black belt. Adam Kayum in his corner as his new head coach. Let's see if Kayum can coach him through this dangerous position. And Eko Roni Saputra gets out.
Saputra gets out. And now we're going to fire shots from his back, though. Kingad delivers a right. Kingad on his back in the blue gloves and red shorts.
This is what I was talking about, the keys to victory at the beginning here, you know.
Big right, Saputra on the way in. And that delivers another one to the head of Kingad.
Launching himself into some ground and pound.
You know, Brent, that was a big right, but I don't think it landed as flush as it may have looked like it did. And this is what I was talking about in the walkout, the keys to victory. Saputra's not going to be able to just sit and guard here and get it done.
Kingad, of course, from the Philippines, and told us as many fighters
going
from
for
that country.
He's trying to shove that arm down, trying to create a little bit of space, lock up that triangle. Kingad's dangerous off his back. Eko Roni needs to do some work here. He needs to free that arm and start dropping some ground and pound. Good top pressure coming from Eko. Let's see if he can clear this knee shield. Oh, he might go for a leg here.
Looking for the heel. Nice little up kick by Kingad there.
Yeah, Eko Roni is coming off that heel hook victory over Y2K. So I know he's been working hard on his grappling, but apparently so has Danny Kingad.
Man, good underhook work there. Kingad starting to come out the backside. Saputra went heavy with his hips, and Kingad was still able to work himself out and end up in half guard on top.
A big branch from Eko Roni, but Kingad's able to settle down, pass the guard. And now is inside control. Looks like Herb Dean's gonna separate them. Gonna try to maintain this position and continue.
Yeah, they just had to get Saputra's hand was wrapped around the rope, so he wanted it out of there.
Oh, easily passes into mount. Danny Kingad sits on top.
If I was Kingad, I would start working my opponent circularly back to the center of the ring. I'd start moving him around so that he doesn't end up sliding out of the ropes here. Because like Kingad's hand is on the outside of the rope, and he just got caught. And that's part of what cost him that position.
Saputra back to his feet now.
Eko Roni Saputra just muscles himself back up to the standing position. And as Danny Kingad was about to fall out the ring, Eko just gives him one for good measure as he lands a calf kick.
Yeah, nice calf kick from Eko Roni Saputra. Final 25 seconds, flying in again as Saputra with an overhand right.
Man, Danny Kingad has been in some wars inside one championship, and this looks to be another one here. And Danny Kingad still only 27 years old as Eko Roni Saputra launches himself into another big shot. Might end up with the Wizard trying to pull him over to the top. Might throw him through the ring ropes.
You know, that was a good moment to point out there that Kingad was kind of stepping back, motioning to the ref like, hey, I got headbutted, but he didn't stop. They always tell him to protect yourself at all time in the ring, and that's exactly what Saputra took advantage of there, stepping forward when the ref didn't stop him.
Man, Rich, look at the strength of Eko Roni Saputra with that Wizard. Trying to really see some great things from a lot of Team Lakai wrestlers or strikers, but man, Danny Kingad could be the most well-rounded Team Lakai member I have seen. But Stefan Lohman looks to take that title away from him as Eko Roni Saputra takes him down with a beautiful little double leg here as Danny Kingad looks to be attacking possibly a Kimura on the far side arm. Let's see if he can do anything with it. Eko Roni Saputra trying to settle in to this back take position. Yep, Danny Kingad has that Kimura. He's going to try to reverse the position, create possibly a sweep. But Eko Roni Saputra so heavy, so strong.
Well, he was able to clear the legs and step around so that Kingad can't get the angle that he needs to actually finish out that Kimura.
Here inside the Mecca of martial arts, historic Lumpini Boxing Stadium. What a night of fights so far. This is the third of seven. Two world titles on the line. Coming up later tonight here in Bangkok.
Hands inside. Stop.
Round two. Saputra Kingad is now Herb going to step in and reset things.
This way.
And we talked about it throughout the night. There is a difference, obviously, between the one circle and fighting in a ring like this. And this is an example where they've got to reset. But try Herb trying to get him back in the same position.
And it's never the same, Brent. You can never restart in the same position, which is why it's so hard to grapple inside the ring.
Fight.
For the fans out there that have actually never seen a match in the ring or competed in one for that matter, this is not a standard boxing ring either. This is a five-rope ring. There's a low rope on the bottom designed to keep the fighters from going out. And the ropes are real tough. Amazing takedown.
Belly to back to take Eko Roni Saputra down. The surprises keep coming, Rich, from Danny Kingad. He said he had some tricks up his sleeve, but the sheer power and explosiveness of Eko Roni Saputra to explode out of some of these bad positions is really impressive.
Yeah, he did a good job there after the takedown. Kingad was in half guard. Saputra was tight on that leg, making Kingad, as he was trying to pass, lift the hips, and he just chose the right time to explode and reverse that position.
You talked about Kingad earlier. His only three losses to Marias, Demetrius Johnson, and Akhmatov. In the DJ fight, he was the current world champion, of course, in this flyweight division. He acquitted himself quite well, did Kingad.
Yeah, he looked really good in that. Kingad is incredibly well-rounded. He's a high-level athlete, especially when he starts to drag fights into the deep water just to reach his keys to victory. Look at him working the body of Eko. Eko says, come on, bring it. You got nothing on me, kid.
Taking it, taking the body, kicking out the outside leg kick. Kingad showing a bit of everything.
Man, Kingad is following Rich Franklin's keys to victory to a T with the calf kicks.
And he's staying very composed in his combinations. When he went to the body before and the head, he's not getting greedy with this stuff because that's where Saputra has the biggest chance, is just unloading with one of those big, as Mitch would say, one-hitter quitters.
Going to the body. This body work is going to pay dividends. He's hit Saputra with four big body shots, and the body language of Saputra has completely changed. He's not used to being on the back foot like this.
Saputra counters with an overhand right. Glanced off of Kingad.
That's where Kingad needs to be careful because Saputra has that one-punch KO power. But man, these combinations, the way he's throwing these, just staying composed and poised on this. He's not getting greedy. So smart.
Saputra needs to get on that jab. He cannot stand there throwing these big looping shots, giving Danny Kingad the opportunity to react.
You know, before this match, we talked about Kingad being the king of decisions. But I have to say this, it might be actually this week.
Danny Kingad choosing his shots carefully like a sniper out there.
That's beautiful work. Nice uppercut follows with the left as Kingad.
So Butcher needs to get on that jab, start working some low kicks. Right now, he's circling right into the power side of Danny Kingad.
Saputra's game plan is falling apart because he was depend on those takedowns to actually control his opponent, and that is his failsafe, and it didn't work for him because he got out-wrestled by Kingad. This is where Kingad needs to be careful, though, because it's that one-punch power that he has.
Yeah, Saputra carries power in that right hand, man. He's kind of leaning on it right now. Smart for Eko to tie him up and try to get out of the second round. Give him a chance to regroup and devise some adjustments that he can make in the third and final round.
Delivers one last shot. Oh, nice high kick there from Danny Kingad. It comes back to the left. Third and final round in the flyweight division. Saputra and Kingad.
Back elbows as Saputra chooses to change the game plan, avoid the striking, and looks to tie up inside that clinch. But I like the way Kingad's using the over-under to create a little bit of space and the ropes to throw those knees.
You see that he'll throw the knee to the midsection, and then when Saputra tries to counter, he just moves that hip forward so that he's not taking any damage to the midsection. Smart play by Kingad.
Eko Roni gets into that high crotch, tries to transition. Picks up the leg. Good balance showcase so far by Danny Kingad, but Eko Roni is able to end up on top here. Puts the hands inside the leg, squeaks around trying to take the back. Kingad's wise to it, knows where he's going, peels off the arm to the side to save himself and get his back take. Look at Kingad transitioning into the single leg. That Iranian wrestling coach has definitely helped Kingad's grappling game, but Eko Roni Saputra able to reverse it, end up on top in the half guard. Look at Kingad working his way back up to his feet, gets the leg, heavy sprawl coming from Saputra.
Three and a half minutes to go. What are you seeing, Rich? I mean, does Eko Roni really need to step it up here? I mean, is Kingad clearly winning this fight right now?
Yeah, Kingad's clearly winning. At the end of round two, he's ahead on the scorecards. Eko Roni's obviously in the control position here as this is beginning to change right in front of our eyes, and that's what I'm talking about right there. But either way, had he remained in that control position, there's not going to be enough to get it done for him there. So now you see Kingad's in the half guard, and he'll begin working from here.
Wow, unofficially, that's three takedowns for Danny Kingad on this high-level wrestler, Eko Roni Saputra, who has hundreds of wrestling matches, Rich.
I'll ask you this. Prior to this fight happening, would you have predicted that Kingad would have won the takedown category on the judge?
I don't know, man. I've seen Kingad throw people with just his legs. So, like, that throw against Eugene Toquero was a thing of beauty, and he did it with just one leg. And so you can never put anything past Danny Kingad. I wish he would have given you a little bit of insight to how far his wrestling has come, because his grappling is on another level right now. Beautiful. Look at that. The way he floated over like that, knew the bridge was coming. The bridge happened two earlier times in this match, and that time Kingad was wise to it, settled into position, followed the hips, allowed Eko to turn over, and now has control of that back position.
Well, prior to that bridge, Kingad was actually looking for the head and arm there. It was almost sunk in, and Saputra had no option but to bridge like that in order to get out of that, giving up his back.
Kingad looks to be attacking the arm. Yep, there's armbar. Beautiful transition. Eko Roni pries his arm free to end up on top.
Saputra's got to get something done, you would think, in this final minute, 43.
And he can do it.
I just said, we talked about Kingad being the king of decisions, but man, what a great match start to finish. Always full of action when Danny's fighting.
Saputra unloading a couple of rights. Not a lot of authority on them, though. Inside of 90 seconds to go, Kingad ranked number 3, 14-3 overall, 10-3 here in one championship. Ranked number 3 in the division.
Yeah, Eko needs to get some points on the board. He needs to start dropping ground and pound, look for a submission, start attacking things. He's got 70 seconds, otherwise his 7-fight win streak might be coming to an end.
All of those wins by first round stoppage, and you made the point early. You wondered as we got deeper into this thing, what kind of cast would be in the tank of Eko Roni Saputra.
I mean, there's definitely an experience advantage that's going to go to the king, and he's leaning on that here. He just knows what to do in all these pivotal situations. Oh, here comes a rear naked choke. He's getting one hook in. I don't think he needs the other one. Kingad's got a good squeeze.
Yeah, no. Saputra's belly down. If he's able to get under the chin, he's not. But he wouldn't need that second hook.
Kingad on the back, delivering rights to the head of Saputra with 25 seconds remaining in the fight. Couple of back fists to the body. 20 seconds to go. Trying to find some space in there and close the show is Kingad to leave no doubt in the minds of the judges.
Good work from Eko Roni to end up on top as he tries to jump past the guard, but Kingad was wise to it.